you realize we've been standing here for 20 minutes?
I know, Peter. But it just doesn't seem right.
We can't change what's about to happen.
Yes.
You remember, our job is to observe, not interfere.
So we're just going to sit here and not talk. It's only for 6 months.
Yeah, right.
Well, what do you want me to do? Carry on like this and give up my dream?
It doesn't matter. You're going to do what you want to do anyway.
Scott, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to be a little more supportive.
So go.
I don't want it to be like this.
Doesn't matter. You do what you have to do, Anne. It's your life.
That's just great. I'm going for a walk.
I've got to take care of something.
Michael, you are not to interfere.
Excuse me. You're Scott Murphy, right?
Yeah? Do I know you?
Not personally. I'm afraid I have some bad news for you.
What is it?
There's no easy way to put this.
Look, I don't know what this is about, but I'm really not interested.
If someone you know is going to die in 5 minutes.
What did you say?
You heard me.
You said someone I know is going to die. Why would you say that? Who are you?
I'm your... My name is Michael.
Okay, Michael.
Piss off!
You insist on making this difficult.
I'll give you one last warning.
Maybe you need some convincing. You're 28 years old, and you're a computer programmer.
That information's on MySpace.
All right, then. May 1998, you were going to a job interview, and you were speeding. You ran over Rose Hanley's dog. She never found out it was you.
You could have talked to any one of my friends.
Except you never told any of your friends.
All right, you got my attention. Who's gonna die? Was it Anne? Well, how does it happen?
I'm afraid I can't tell you anymore.
What, is she hit by a bus? Is she hit by a car? I mean, does she drown? What is it?
I don't know how it happens.
Do you have something to do with this?
Of course not. Look, I've done the best I can. I can't tell you anymore.
Yeah, well, you know what? I don't believe you. I think someone put you up to this.
You want to spend these last moments arguing with me? Look, Scott, I've taken a great risk in doing this. You're running out of time, and it seems to me you're wasting it. This girl is upset with you. And you need to make things right.
Just stop it. I've heard enough.
You've been in this situation before, Scott.
I'm not listening to this.
June 18th, 2002. You were on your way to the airport to pick up your father. You were running late. You had no money for parking.
How is this relevant?
He called you irresponsible, and that started a full-on argument. And then he collapsed. You called an ambulance, but by the time they got there, it was too late. Heart attack, wasn't it?
That's enough!
That's the last memory that you have of your father. A pointless argument over a parking fee. This is it, Scott. The home stretch. Now I could be lying. But what if I'm not? Are you willing to take that risk? It's your call.
I'm not in the mood, Scott.
I want to talk to you.
What's the point? You've made your feelings pretty obvious.
I know how important this acting scholarship is to you. I should have been more supportive.
Why are you saying this now?
Because life is too short to argue about things like this. Anne, I do want you to be happy.
You know, you broke every rule in the book.
I didn't specify who was going to die.
Regardless, there's going to be consequences.
Yes. But it was worth it. Of course, now Anne's going to be by herself.
Not necessarily. She carries his child.